Hi everyone, I'm Pushpa Aman Singh, founder and CEO of GuideStar India, which I set up in the year 2009. And from 2017, I also wear very proudly another hat, Global Leader for Giving Tuesday in India. Giving Tuesday started 6 years ago in the United States to kind of offset, you know, the heavy shopping that happens Black Friday, Cyber Monday, after the Thanksgiving weekend. And a bunch of people in New York, Henry Timms and Asha Karan, thought it'll be a great idea to use the fantastic digital medium which people now use to connect with one another, like Facebook, to why not kind of put those to doing good. And I'm so happy that India already had Daan Utsav, which started way back in the year 2009. We're today in the 11th year, day two. And Giving Tuesday India, like I said, 3 years ago, this is the third year, celebrated every year on the Tuesday of Daan Utsav, which starts with the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, 2nd to 8th October. And we were so thrilled that yesterday was also the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. And so many of you out there in India came on to celebrate your generosity, your kindness, and your giving. GuideStar India is so proud to anchor Giving Tuesday India with our vast network of over 9,000 nonprofit organizations who kind of put out their commitment to transparency and public accountability by putting out their activities and their compliance details and all of that on GuideStarIndia.org, so that when you celebrate Daan Utsav and Giving Tuesday India, you have credible nonprofits with whom you can connect and do so much more social impact. I'm so proud that today we're going to be talking about Daan Utsav and Giving Tuesday India celebrations. I have with me Sandeep Kumar, who is the head of brand marketing from Mumbai Metro One. And it's so interesting and nice to have Sandeep here, because when we talk about taking out time to do good and celebrations for people in a busy city like Mumbai, and for that matter, you know, so many of the cities in India, going to do good is like a separate agenda altogether. So it's wonderful if we can bring activities to do good and organizations that kind of are leaders in sensitizing people and making civic action possible, bring them face to face in public spaces without having to take out that extra time. So I'm really curious to know, Sandeep, from you. Mumbai Metro One has been celebrating Daan Utsav for so many years now. So why is it important to you? It's on your calendar. And what's special about this year?
Hey, thank you, Pushpa, for coming this year with us. And frankly speaking, Mumbai Metro One, from its inception days, from 2014, has been doing one of its CSRs, very important property, I would say, to give back to the society. Daan Utsav, we started in 2014, and we have been doing this from last 5 years. And this is the sixth year. When we were planning for 2019 Daan Utsav, we were also thinking about how to not only sensitize, but make commuters feel the pull of it. We have been doing a lot of activities, which has been a push strategy. So people are actually thriving towards the commuters and asking for some kind of donations, which was kind of resistive every time. We have been plying around 4.5 to 4.8 lakh people in a day. And it's very imperative to understand their situation also. So we were positive about doing this activity with Daan Utsav, Giving Tuesday India, making it more, activity-based, more communicative, where people feel the need of it and they would come forward to the donations and participate in the voluntary activities.
So Sandeep, I know we've always been talking about how to engage commuters in a conversation around a theme that's very important to people of the city. And when we first met, you talked about women's empowerment. So could you just share, like, how do you visualize commuters participating, or what is it that you think they will take away from this entire week of celebrations, activities that are also a little beyond fun, and for people to get to know issues around them, for commuters themselves, as well as, you know, the surroundings through which they pass. Like, we had conversations about safety around stations, within stations and stuff. So I'm really curious to know why women's empowerment.
Yes. So as I told, Mumbai Metro One is into public transportation services. We are having a Warsowa Andheri Ghatkopar corridor. If you see geographically, Ghatkopar is having the origin point for Thane, Raigad and Mumbai districts. And you have lot many places in and around these three big corridors. And there are huge amount of women, girls who are traveling in this metro line. We are always thinking about how to make their journey safe. Not only journey the safer, but how this entire experience has to be safe, starting from their home to some feeders and reaching out to the metro station, coming onto the metro station, getting into the trains, and again coming out of it, going to their offices. So if you see, there is an entire circle which revolves around. Why I would say women empowerment and safety? Because it's been not encountered from a long time, at least in the Indian travel scenario. We are putting a lot of efforts to make the Mumbai stations and the travel pretty safe, and it's our prime focus and objective always. But how to sensitize people in around this corridor, that was very, very important. So all these commuters who are going to come at the stations are going to talk to all these seven NGOs whom we have associated with, and they're trying to get aware actually about it. They might not know that, you know, the nearby area is having so many issues and how they can actually contribute towards it. So this theme about women and girl empowerment has come from that aspect to it.
When we were planning, for what types of activities, you made us aware about this huge two types of Mumbais that exist. Especially, you also referred to it now, a whole lot of people actually going to work who face some of the issues, you know, that need to be addressed in their own lives, meaning they are people who might need more help from some of the NGOs. And when they kind of cross over, I believe, the Western Express Highway, you have a set of people who can actually help in addressing these problems. So in a sense, you have two sets of people, and there are the NGOs, and the metro kind of connects these two types of populations. And could you just talk a little bit about the types of activities, therefore, that you've planned? Because you said about seven NGOs, you've picked different stations. Some of our people who are participating or watching this chat that we're having would be wanting to, if they're in and around Mumbai, I'm sure they're going to come to the metro stations, and this might help them kind of be prepared about what they could participate in. I'm also thinking about, you know, the long weekends and the festive vacation time in some parts of India. So we're also going to have people from outside of Mumbai who are visitors to the city, and I think the holidays are a great time for them to come. So could you just talk a little bit about what these activities are?
Of course. So as you correctly mentioned, that we are, this whole line is very crucial and critical when we see the demography, the kind of people they come from, and the place they where they go. As I told you, Thane, Raigad and Mumbai, three districts getting connected in Ghatkopar station, and 80% of offices are till Western Express Highway, till Andheri station connecting to the Western line. There are lakhs of people who are going to travel to that point, and from there they come to Warsowa, DN Nagar and Azad Nagar. Now there are two sets of people actually traveling here. people who are involved there in their own lives. They have their own issues, but they can't actually help. Now, beyond a point of time, you will have a lot of people who are more resourceful, who can actually contribute to the society. It is imperative to understand how people behave when you talk to them about their problems. So we decided to do the activities with the NGOs in a way that from Ghatkopar till Western Express Highway, we have set of activities to sensitize people, to make them aware that this is a problem and this is the problem you need to talk about. You can't just shut your mouth. And after that point of time, we will have activities which will entice people to, you know, donate, to make volunteer activities with them. So this is how we try to collaborate with all the NGOs through you. And we are trying to get more and more data around it. No system can be 100% secure and safe. I can be a secure premise, but how about my ecosystem? And this ecosystem has to be safe first. And then only we can say that, you know, my metro, Mumbai Metro One, is safer commute system. So the entire idea came out through that. And that is how we have prepared for this entire activities at the seven stations.
You kind of talked about data. And I remember the emphasis on wanting to know exactly, you know, so not just fun, but there's some people will contribute to support activities to improve the city, its safety parameters, and, you know, how people can be comfortable while traveling. And the other is also to kind of learn people's concerns. So I suppose some of the activities that were planned out were like a survey to know what people feel, letting certain issues bubble up. And I think you were very particular that there is a kind of a report back or a tracking on, you know, number of people who were engaged, what were their before, after concerns, did they learn a couple of things after interacting or being sensitized through a number of games. So I think that's a very important message to kind of put back out there, because I think there are maybe the other metros are watching this, or maybe other companies who do their CSR, how it's important to kind of complete the loop by taking this feedback. And then hopefully beyond this 1 week of Daan Utsav, ending with Giving Tuesday India on 8th of October, we're going to have issues that can be, you know, addressed in a very concrete fashion. I suppose that's what you were planning to do,
yeah,
right?
Absolutely correct. See, we have been doing a lot of activities at our stations, and not only us, but a lot of other companies are doing that in their own way and manner. When I say doing an activity at station or at any point of time or any point of place, we need to have exact deliverables, what you're going to achieve from there. It is not only important from a corporate perspective, but from an NGO perspective also. I have seen people having kiosks with the agenda to just talk to a few people and do some activities around that. But over here, the objective has to be sensitizing, making people aware about it, and just not feeding the numbers. You know, so when I say this, that means how we are actually impacting the ecosystem around us. It comes to us. And when we take the data, we also try to understand that, okay, these are the points which we need to work upon. Again, not only my station, but maybe in and around that entire area is my concern. So within these 2nd to 8th of October activities, we have to understand and we have to accept that whatever we are doing in these days has to have a proper deliverable data for everyone, for each stakeholder, NGOs, GuideStar India, and Mumbai Metro One, so that this whole activity does not go without any results. So that was the entire thought process around that.
That's really nice to know. And in fact, you brought it out during our conversations that it's not just sensitizing and getting the data, but also support for the cause that these organizations are carrying out. And you've been generous to kind of say that they can wear their QR codes, the UPI QR code, which is now popular for people to, if they feel moved or if they feel like they have the power, which everyone has, to make that small immediate contribution. You know, they can actually just scan and contribute for some of the services which our friends from the NGOs will be talking about. I think you've said that they can actually charge for some of those services or take donations for that. So in a sense, it's nice to know that you're really mindful of the issues that are important to make this very sustainable. I'm also really happy that this is a great example of collaboration and innovation and unbranding that Giving Tuesday India and Giving Tuesday Worldwide stands for, that when we are doing this to celebrate Daan Utsav, Giving Tuesday, etc., we put our branding not as the main thing, but coming together in a collaborative fashion, trying out new things and fixing some problems that seemed very complex and challenging till now. I mean, I'd like to close this conversation with you giving us a flavor of what you saw yesterday on the first day around Mumbai Metro and any message that you want to give out to people there.
Yeah, so October 2nd was an eventful day at our stations, undoubtedly. Being a 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, also coming with Daan Utsav at the stations, you will see skit plays, you will see some great activities coming up, events coming up at these stations. I would request all my commuters of Mumbai, Thane and Raigarh who are traveling on this line to come at the stations and do visit these kiosks the NGOs have set up. It's a great way to learn about these issues and contribute towards that. Thank you.
Thanks. And I would actually urge people to come out, especially those who don't use the metro. The holiday time is a great time. The afternoons are great. The evenings are wonderful for office commuters to kind of pause, take a breather and enjoy as well as learn. So happy Daan Utsaving and happy Mumbai Metro One rides in the coming days.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thank you very much. I hope so.
So let's look at some of the pictures from yesterday.
Please.
So we will see, I think, Sandeep, you want to explain what Apnalaya was doing or what people did at the Trinayani installations, etc.?
Yeah, so if you see, the stations are having a lot of activities to make people know that what's going on. We are doing a lot of announcement at the stations within the trains, and a lot of videos are being played in the LCD screens of trains so that while standing or sitting in the train, they can actually see what they are going to see, and that will make them to step out of the rush hour crowd, and they can stop by these stalls.
Thank you so much, Sandeep, for the generosity of Mumbai Metro One, the work that you're doing at the stations and to make Mumbai a happier and better place. I would now say that was a fine example of a business or a corporation, including a public service, trying to do good. I'd like us to hear from one of the philanthropists of the country and of the world, who is also supporting Giving Tuesday India and Daan Utsav as a concept, Rohini Nilakani. She kind of tells how it's important for Samaj, Sarkar and Bazaar to come together, and tackling some of the problems in India is not something that any one of these sectors can do. It calls for collective action, and I'm really privileged to be a part of this. I'd like for us to hear this message from Ms. Rohini Nilakani.
I just wanted to take this opportunity to say how proud I was to be associated with Giving Tuesday and with the Daan Utsav. And I wanted to thank GuideStar for its leadership in enabling the civil society organizations, as well as the philanthropic community and the corporate community, to enable a lot more people of this country to participating in the what I'm calling the empathy sector, which is when we have so many deep, complex societal problems, no one sector can even hope to address them and to solve them. We need all sectors of society to come together. And I think this is a great beginning, and I'm sure it's going to go from strength to strength.
So we heard from Sandeep Kumar earlier in the conversation about Mumbai Metro One stations with seven different leading credible organizations of Mumbai engaging citizens during the entire week of Daan Utsav, ending with Giving Tuesday India on October 8th, engaging something like between 4 to 6 lakh daily commuters. So that's a lot of people, and we have from the seven organizations, three of them here with me in conversation now, and main ko tarah tarah ke questions poochne wali hu. So I'm going to request each of them to introduce themselves. We'll start with Ritika from Trinayani. So Ritika, tell us a bit about yourself, what Trinayani does, and then we'll come back again asking you about your activities for Daan Utsav Giving Tuesday.
Thank you, Pushpa. I'm Ritika Sahni. I'm the founder trustee of the NGO called Trinayani. I'm a singer activist. I'm a consultant in disability inclusion. Trinayani focuses on creating awareness about disability and diversity issues. We design and conduct sensitization and awareness workshops for corporates, for the education sector, for airlines, for the Election Commission of India. We use, and that's the exciting part, we use non-cliched ways of promoting inclusiveness through games, through curated events, literature, films, posters, poems, and to challenge the stereotypes that people have about disabilities. So whatever we do, it's all aimed at challenging the stereotypes that the non-disabled person or the population has about persons with disabilities.
That's really interesting and nice, because when we are in a busy city like Mumbai and just commuting, trying to get into work at the right time after all the rains and, you know, all the dhamal that happens, it's nice to know that. And I'm really going to come back and ask you about those activities and exactly how it's going to literally open our eyes and ears about interacting with people who are disabled or differently abled, and how do we kind of build that awareness into how we have a more inclusive and happy society. Thank you for that. Mumtaz ji, aap hame batayenge ki about yourself aur koro kya karta hai aur specifically kis mudda ya baat ko leke aap log ye Daan Utsav Giving Tuesday India mana rahe hain.
जी, मैं मुमताज शेख हूँ. कोरो इंडिया इस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से जुड़ी हुई हूँ और पिछले 30 सालों से ग्रास रूट लीडरशिप, वीमेन एम्पावरमेंट, जेंडर सेंसिटाइजेशन को लेकर कोरो गांवों में, बस्तियों में काम करता है. कोर है जिनके सवाल उनका नेतृत्व, तो जो जिनके सवाल है वही लीडरशिप कर रहे हैं और जो चेंज मेकर है. अगर आप बदलाव लाने चाहते हो किसी भी चीज़ में, तो जिनके जिनके साथ बदलाव लाना है उन्हीं को इसमें उतरना होगा. ये है. और पावर टू वाली जो बात है, पावर विद इन वाली जो बात है, इसी को हाथ में लेते हुए ग्रास रूट फेलोशिप के माध्यम से हम काम कर रहे हैं महाराष्ट्र, राजस्थान और दिल्ली में. और करीबन 1150 लीडर्स तैयार हुए हैं जो अपने अपने गाँवों में, अपने अपने बस्तियों में बदलाव का काम ला रहे हैं. तो बस इसी की एक झलक हम मेट्रो स्टेशन पे भी दिखा रहे हैं.
बहुत खूब. और आपने बताया कि यही चेंज मेकर्स जो बदलाव लेके आए हैं उन्हीं के साथ लोग संपर्क में आएंगे एंड दे विल हैव दोस कॉन्वर्सेशंस, जिससे होपफुली वो इन बातों को और अच्छी तरह से समझ सके. क्योंकि इनमें से लोग हैं जिन्होंने अपने आप लड़ाई किया है बहुत सारे वायलेंस और डिफिकल्ट सिचुएशंस में. और अक्सर ऐसा होता है हमारे घरों में, व्हेन वी हैव पीपल हेल्पिंग अस गेट ऑन विद आवर लाइफ, जो इन मुद्दों के साथ अपने घरों में उलझ रहे हैं, हम कभी कभी उनके लिए वक्त नहीं निकाल पाते और समझ नहीं पाते क्यों कोई देरी से आते हैं या कभी क्यों मुंह सुझा हुआ होता है. एज अ ले पर्सन आई एम सेइंग, सो आज आपसे बात करके आई होप वी विल लर्न अ लिटिल बिट मोर बिफोर वी कम टू द स्टेशंस एंड यू नो टॉक टू द चेंज मेकर्स.
यू नो पुष्पा, देयर इज समथिंग वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग शी सेड एंड दैट्स इंपॉर्टेंट, कि नथिंग अबाउट अस विदाउट अस. आप जिसके लिए काम करना चाहते हैं उसकी आवाज भी आनी चाहिए. अक्सर क्या होता है, जब जहां तक विकलांगता का सवाल है, जो विकलांग नहीं है वो विकलांगता के बारे में बोलता है. तो ये जरूरी हो जाता है कि जो विकलांग है वो ही सामने आकर अपने जरूरतों के बारे में बात करे, अपने नीड्स के बारे में बात करे, अपने अधिकार के लिए बात करे. सो नथिंग अबाउट अस विदाउट अस.
थैंक यू रितिका फॉर रीट्रेटिंग दैट. एंड आई विल टर्न टू यू नीता फ्रॉम स्नेहा. Sneha itne saalon se kaam kar raha hai, and it's a privilege for me to, you know, be chatting with you, a platinum certified partner of GuideStar India. So aap apne bare mein, apne organization ke bare mein kuch bataiye. Let us know.
Yes, I'm Neeta Karandikar. I work with the Adolescent Health and Empowerment Program of Sneha. So Sneha stands for Society for Nutrition, Education and Health Action. We are a trust where we are working on four public health areas, which is child health and nutrition, maternal and newborn health, prevention of violence against women and children, and empowerment, health and sexuality of adolescents. So I represent the adolescent program. In the Metro campaign, we are going to focus mainly on two programs, that is the empowerment, health and sexuality of adolescents, and also the prevention of violence against women and children. So there are different activities like street plays, an interactive Ludo game on mental health and gender-based violence, photo exhibition and where the selfie point where people can take photographs and click selfies along with placards in their hand regarding the gender-based equality attitude. And we are
so
also,
that's really selfie with a difference.
Yeah.
Or Giving Tuesday globally, जब मनाया जाता है, एक unselfie का concept होता है, जहाँ पे आप selfless selfie खींचते हैं. So I'm glad to know कि Sneha के वहाँ पे लोग आके station में, आपका कौन सा station में होने वाला है?
Marol.
Marol Naka. So wonderful. So Marol Naka से जैसे आप गुजरेंगे, तो please look out for these. You know, the photo exhibition, taking selfies with placards and messages and pledge to make a difference with those messages. Yes. And not just a selfie.
Yes.
So great to hear that. I'll turn to you, Ritika. I know that at DN Nagar, there's a lot that's going to happen. I heard about performance, Snakes and Ladders, Game with a Difference, and also a food spa with a difference. Yes. So just tell us a bit more about it.
So at DN Nagar station, we have two of our blind therapists. Who would be providing reflexology massage. The idea here is, aap jab hamare desh mein, which is very donation charity oriented, aap jab kisi bhi ek daan dena, aur jab aap massage karvayenge, aap ek service ke against mein ek 100 rupaye denge. To wo jo len den hai, it's a very interesting, respectful, dignified len den. So I'm hoping that people jo DN Nagar station mein aana jana aate jate hain, wo ek, and of course a beautiful massage, a relaxing
and
massage.
For 15 minutes?
It's 15 minutes. And
only 100 rupees.
And only 100 rupees, yes.
Oh, lovely.
Because we want people, sure. because aksar kya hota hai, jab wo baithte hain, to unke saath baatcheet bhi shuru karte hain. And the blind therapist, then, you know, I have kind of motivated them ki jab bhi tumse koi puchega acha tum train se kaise aati ho to baat karo, because ye ignorance hi ye distance create kar raha hai. So if people get more informed about how people with disabilities live, I'm sure they're going to be much closer. To ek wo hai, ek bahut interesting cheez jo wahan hai is, there's an exhibition, there's an exhibit, Let's Talk exhibit. Ye ek sculpture hai, teen sculpture wahan rakhe gaye hain jisko banaya hai ek deaf blind ne ek non-disabled sculptor ke saath. So it's an inclusive event. Trinayani mein hum jitna bhi kaam karte hain, wo sab inclusive hota hai. Jo viklang hai aur jo viklang nahi hai, milkar karte hain. So this is a very interesting sculpture called Let's Talk, which tells people about sign language. So it's made of A, B, C, D,
E. People can touch it.
People can touch it and feel ke jo ek deaf blind hai, ya jo deaf hai, wo kis tarah se communicate karta hai. Agar भाषा का इस्तेमाल नहीं करता, लेकिन संप्रेषण या कम्युनिकेशन इज स्टिल हैपनिंग.
Do you want to just talk a little bit about what is deaf blindness? Because I don't think many people understand.
So deaf blindness is a multiple disability where you have two disabilities. You could be deaf and have blindness. Degrees vary. You could have a visual impairment, which is mild visual impairment, a profound deafness. So ये जो profoundly deaf blind है, उसके लिए communication का एक ही तरीका है, that is sign language. And what they do is, they use one, the American sign language, which is one hand, because they use the other hand to feel the words or the alphabets. So that one-handed sign alphabets A to Z is what has been used to create that sculptor. And we have a proper write-up there. So wo hai wahan. Pushpa, along with DN Nagar, I'm also personally going to be at Azad Nagar, mm-hmm. because the area is much to play the snakes and ladder game. That's happening okay. at Azad Nagar. And I must tell everybody, so in case you want to know about sign language, on Monday, we have 12 hearing impaired students who are coming to play that. Mm-hmm. And they would be playing that and the things would be explained to them in sign language.
Okay.
And on Tuesday or tomorrow, we have another set of 12 coming who are deaf but don't know sign language.
Okay.
So that's what you need to understand, that that diversity, even people with disabilities are diverse. I'm deaf, I know sign language. I'm deaf, I don't know sign language. I might be blind, I know Braille. I might be blind, but I don't know Braille. So, aisa nahi hai, you stereotype jo karne ka hamara tarika rehta hai ki sare blind ek jaise hote hain, sab deaf, aisa nahi hai. Wo, the diversity is there everywhere.
So that sounds really interesting. And for those who are wondering about kitne baje kya kahan pe hone wala hai, all these events are put up on givingtuesdayindia.org.
Yes.
Aur aap website mein events pe jayenge, to ye sare details milenge, and you can read about all of these organizations, what they're doing, so that you can continue supporting them. And they all are so transparent. Every little thing that you want to know about their organizations are actually in public domain.
Yes.
That's the beautiful aspect to this. Ki aksar log sochte hain ki aaj Metro One stations pe mil liya NGO ko, baad mein inse sampark mein karna hai, kuch aage badke you feel like volunteering with them, you want to dedicate more of your time to the cause. All the details are there. Aur kab kahan kya ho raha hai, ye bhi hai. It's just that since it's a public space and the commuters come and go, exact timing cannot be given. But given that you have holidays, I think all of you can take out a little time and be with your families, go with friends.
I have a
Pahli
Barish happening tomorrow. The Inclusive Music Band. Our Inclusive Music Band, which comprises of musicians with and without disability, hum ek ghante ka Bollywood show kar rahe hain.
Okay.
At DN Nagar Metro Station. So everybody is invited for that show.
So the 4th of October.
That's on the 4th. At 4th of October between 5 and 7 p.m.
Okay.
At DN Nagar Metro Station.
Okay.
Pehli Barish.
And we will try to get that to you, you know, during the rest of the week. Sometime or the other, you will have the videos on Giving Tuesday India. Definitely on the Facebook page. And hopefully on the website as well. Abhi Mumtaz ji, aap humko bataiye ki jo karyakram hone wala hai, kaun se station mein, aur log jab aayenge, what they can expect, aur kitna waqt lagega, aur unse aap kya karayenge?
Do teen cheeze hum wahan pe kar rahe hain. Ek to hamara photo exhibition hai. कुछ स्टिकर्स हमने बनाए, हमारी राइट टू पी कैंपेन सभी को पता है कि महिलाओं के लिए
राइट टू पी, थोड़ा बताइए ना
जी.
शायद सबको नहीं पता, आई नो वी ऑल फील इट.
राइट टू पी कैंपेन बेसिकली महिलाओं के लिए फ्री क्लीन सेफ पब्लिक यूरिनल्स होने चाहिए, इसके लिए पिछले 8 सालों से काम कर रहा है मुंबई महानगर पालिका के साथ और अभी महाराष्ट्र के अलग अलग जिले में, जहाँ पे हम चाहते हैं कि महिलाओं के लिए पेशाब घर हो, जहाँ पे वो जा सके, वो सेफ हो, क्लीन हो, इसके लिए ये लड़ाई शुरू है. और बहुत सारे चेंजेस उसके बाद आए हैं, तो उसके कुछ स्टिकर है, क्योंकि बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि महिलाओं के लिए टॉयलेट की अगर बात करें तो लोगों को शर्म लगती है कि इसके बारे में कैसी बात करें, या ये भी कोई मुद्दा है क्या. तो उसके कुछ स्टिकर हमने बनाए कि अगर शेक्सपियर होता तो वो क्या कहता, तो उस लाइन पे है, या मैं आपका टॉयलेट यूज़ कर सकती हूँ क्या, क्योंकि टॉयलेट के बारे में बात करना, क्योंकि उसको गंदगी में देखा जाता है, लेकिन अगर हम देखें तो डिग्निटी का सवाल है, मोबिलिटी का सवाल है, और जो भारतीय संविधान ने हमें अधिकार दिए हैं उसको ही कहीं तो नकारा गया है. तो ऐसे कुछ स्टिकर है, जेंडर बेस्ड वायलेंस के स्टिकर है, जैसे मैम ने कहा सेल्फी स्टैंड के बारे में, तो हमने भी एक सेल्फी स्टैंड रखा है कि जो लोग वॉयलेंस को रोकना चाहते हैं और जो वो चेंज मेकर से बात करेंगे तो वहाँ पे ज़्यादा गपशप नहीं होगी, क्योंकि वो फोटोज जो है वही हम वही अपनी कहानी बयान करेंगे और वो सामने है, तो अगर लोगों को वहाँ पे बात करें, क्योंकि बहुत बार ऐसा होता है कि ग्रास रूट में जो बदलाव होता है, वहाँ पे जो माइंड शिफ्ट होता है, उसके बारे में कभी बात नहीं होती और ना ही उसको रिकग्नाइज किया जाता है. मतलब कुछ भी अगर सवाल हो तो लोग कहते हैं वो बस्ती के लोगों में के साथ ऐसा ही होता है, वॉयलेंस तो वहीं पे दिखाई देता है, टॉयलेट तो वहीं पे खराब होते हैं, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है। ये सारी सिचुएशन रहने के बाद भी लोगों ने बदलाव लाए और वो बदलाव की शुरुआत खुद से की। अगर मैं आज यहाँ पे बात कर रही हूँ तो मैंने अपने साथ होने वाले डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस को चैलेंज किया, चेंज किया और आज मैं आके यहाँ पे बात कर रही हूँ। तो बस यही थीम है, लोग वहाँ पे जाएंगे तो लोगों से बात करेंगे। हमारे कम्युनिटी के यूथ है जो अभी अपने अपने घरों में पाबंदी को लेकर लड़ रहे हैं, पढ़ाई को लेकर लड़ रहे हैं और उन्होंने बदलाव लाया है, वो वहाँ पे हैं। तो बस हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि हमारा एक फ्लैश मॉब वहाँ पे हो, जो अभी हमने नवरात्रि उत्सव और गणपति उत्सव में किया था, ताकि लोग ये भी सोचते हैं कि कम्युनिटी में ये सारी चीज़ें नहीं होती है। फ्लैश मॉब किसी और लोगों की बात है, वो ज़्यादा एकेडमिक और ये सारी चीज़ों में देखते हैं। तो ये सारी चीज़ें हम वहाँ पे रखने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं।
बहुत खूब।
और हम बिल्कुल चाहते हैं कि हमें पता नहीं कि कैसे होगा या चैरिटी को हम कैसे देखते हैं, लेकिन हम चाहते हैं कि वो आकर अगर दो मिनट बात भी करे लोगों के साथ तो वो भी बहुत बड़ी बात होती, क्योंकि आप रिकग्नाइज करते हो, आप इंसान हो, ये आप वहाँ पे दिखलाते हो। और यही ज़रूरत है, मोटिवेशन की ज़रूरत है लोगों को, जो लोग काम कर रहे हैं उसको सराहने की ज़रूरत है। तो हम कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि कम से कम लोग आकर हमसे बात करें और जो चैरिटी की बात है या दान की बात है, तो बिल्कुल जो लोग इसको चाहते हैं कि बदलाव हो, वो चाहते हैं कि अपने घरों से शुरुआत हो। और एक बात जो मैं भूल गई, हमने वहाँ पे पोस्ट कार्ड रखे हैं, क्योंकि बहुत बार जैसे आपने कहा कि वायलेंस होता है तो लोगों के चेहरे से पता चलता है और हम पूछते, बहुत बार पूछते नहीं पूछते, तो हमने पोस्ट कार्ड वहाँ पे रखा है जिसके ऊपर हमारा एड्रेस है, फ़ोन नंबर है। जो भी महिलाएं वायलेंस से गुजर रही हैं, बस वो अपना नंबर भी लिख के अगर वो पोस्ट कार्ड हमें भेजती है, या जो लोग देख रहे हैं वायलेंस के बारे में, ये बहुत बार होता है कि लोग आवाज़ नहीं देते हैं, हमेशा ये गुजारिश होती है कि जिनके साथ हो रहा है वही बात करें, लेकिन जो देख रहे हैं
जो बाईस्टैंडर है,
बिल्कुल उन्होंने भी इसमें आना चाहिए और वो पोस्ट कार्ड लेकर जाए, उसके ऊपर वो लिखे और हम उन्हें मदद करेंगे, ये हम वहाँ पे बताना चाहते हैं।
आप वो पोस्ट कार्ड जरूर शेयर कीजिए।
जी जी बिल्कुल,
हम हमारे फेसबुक पेज में डालेंगे उसको और वेबसाइट में, ताकि सारे देश में लोग सिमिलर इश्यूज जो उलझ रहे हैं, दे कैन लुक फॉर लोकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस। एंड आई थिंक आफ्टर हियरिंग व्हाट यू आर डूइंग प्लस द अदर फोर ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हु आर नॉट हियर इन कॉन्वर्सेशन टुडे, जो अपना लिया है, जिनके स्किट्स एंड आई थिंक सेल ऑफ बैग्स है, वी हैव रेड डॉट फाउंडेशन डूइंग सेफ्टी ऑडिट्स, एंड वी हैव सोसाइटी फॉर बिहेवियरल चेंज एंड कम्युनिकेशन, जो एक डांडिया कर रहे हैं मेंटल हेल्थ के ऊपर। तो ये सारा डिटेल्स आपको गिविंग ट्यूजडे इंडिया डॉट ऑर्ग वेबसाइट पे और फेसबुक पेज के इवेंट सेक्शन में मिलेगा। आई वुड से जस्ट गो आउट एंड जैसे मुमताज जी ने बताया और रितिका जी ने और आपने बताया, स्पेंड टाइम, आप दो वक्त बिजी स्टेशन से गुजर रहे हैं तब जस्ट गिव अ फ्यू मोमेंट्स। इट्स ग्रेट दैट मुंबई मेट्रो वन स्टेशंस हैव मेड दिस स्पेस अवेलेबल अलोंग योर डेली पाथ, सो यू नॉट रियली टेकिंग आउट सेपरेटली टाइम। और छुट्टियों में जो घर में सोच रहे हैं कि आप क्या करें, या जैसे विजयदशमी है, दशहरा है, पीपल एंड इट्स द डे ऑफ गिविंग ट्यूजडे इंडिया, नॉर्मली वी गो टू मीट आवर फ्रेंड्स एंड रिलेटिव्स, वाई नॉट टेक द मेट्रो वन एंड यू नो स्टॉप बाय एट दीज स्टेशंस, लेस ट्रैफिक होगा एंड गिव टाइम टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग दीज इश्यूज, हु नोज इट माइट बी यू नो द फर्स्ट स्टेप टू अ कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट लाइफ, अ मोर इंक्लूसिव एंड हैप्पी मुंबई। फॉर दोज ऑफ यू हु आर नॉट इन मुंबई, टू रीड अबाउट दीज अमेजिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, गिविंग ट्यूजडे इंडिया डॉट ऑर्ग इज द वेबसाइट। दो दे सेड दे आर नॉट लुकिंग एट द मनी, बट यू नो योर टाइम टू क्रिएट द अवेयरनेस, I would say, you know, it's always welcome throughout Giving Tuesday India. What we are trying to say is every drop counts. So never feel that India's problems are so big ki what can you do? Also, aap ye mat sochiye ki 10 rupiya bhi chota amount hai. 10-10 rupiya milke off late campaigns ne dikhaya hai. And now we have technology with digital payments. You know, the cost of giving a donation and making it reach the right organization is very easy to do. So I would say experience the joy of giving truly, yes, during Danutsav, and just go out and celebrate, donate, you know, make a difference. And like we say in our tagline, my giving for my better Bharat. So thanks all
thank
of you.
Thank you so much.
It's thank been you. A pleasure talking. Thank you. Thank you.